ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णम् उदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ ब्रह्मानन्दं परं सुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। ॐ एडोरेशन्स् टु सद्गुरु हु इस् ब्रह्मन् द गिवर् आफ् सुप्रीम् ब्लिस् एम्बोडिमेण्ट् आफ् प्योर् कान्शियस्नेस् One without a second, vast as the ether, infinite, eternal, beyond the three gunas and their modifications, the supreme preceptor. Yoga Vasistha, Nirvana, Prakarana, Purvārdha, section 61 continues. Long dream of the world process. It's a profound topic. And what you are being led to understand that I am in you is I am in all, and all countless souls, they are nothing but one absolute soul. Follow the simple illustration. The sun is only one. But there are countless reflected suns in countless reservoirs of water. So, now try to understand the allegorical presentation. You can describe all the reflected suns as the dream of one of the reflected suns. Any one of the reflected suns is the sun. So put yourself in sun status. Then all reflections are like in dream. They are not reality. Any reflected sun, when wakes up to spiritual enlightenment, is the absolute sun. This profound theme is brought before you, and as we continue, we will deal with them. The creation arises in a moment and disappears in a moment, even like the streams during monsoon times. The streams arise and begin to flow with a violent impetuosity. With the subsiding of the rain, they vanish. So does the stream of the world process arise, led by the subtle desires of the citta. But it subsides when knowledge rends the veil of ignorance. Ignorance can work wonders. Both can work wonders, ignorance and knowledge. But first, see the wonders of ignorance. Nothing is impossible for a dreaming person to experience or to encounter. In building castles of the air, nothing stops you from your imagination. Similarly, nothing stops you from dreaming. You can dream of extreme joy, extreme sorrow, And all that you dream is illusory. The entire creation is a dream of cosmic mind. There is nothing that a dream cannot render real. There is nothing that a dream cannot render unreal. You can easily understand that. Thus, guided by the dreaming sankalpas of the mind, the soul's experience numerous forms of the world process. Like a deer falling from one pit to another, dear soul. The souls, led by the illusion of ignorance, continue to fall from one embodiment to another. In section 62, the story of the bhikshu, a special parable is being given by sage Vasistha, and it is elaborating this point that all your experiences are like a dream. And to understand that further extension, your dream is dream within a dream process. Because whenever you enter into dream, even in dream, you are talking about your dream with your friends, dream friends. And that opens the door to dream within the dream within the dream. Remember the illustration of a dog in the barber shop. The dog goes into the old style barber shop where parallel mirrors are placed, mirror one side, mirror on the other, facing each other. And the dog goes in between. He looks into the mirror, there is another dog. Shouts, and the shouts resonate from the other area. He looks back, there is another dog. So he raises his eyebrows, looks behind the dog, there is another dog. Looks back, finds there is a series of dogs. The same you may describe, that in your dream you find one set of experience. Then it opens the door to another dream, and then another dream. But ultimately, you are the only one real behind all that. And this point is brought through this parable. Sage Vasistha said, O Rama, I will relate to you an ancient story to illustrate the movements of the soul from one illusion to another. Once there lived a mendicant devoted to the practice of samadhi. That's the Sanskrit word, the bhikshu, lived in an ashram. He passed his days in the observances of the rules of the ashram. What are the things he practiced? By the practice of serenity, control of senses, listening to scriptures, meditation and samadhi, his chitta became so subtle and sensitive that he could become identified with whatever he meditated upon. This type of siddhi is called samapatti. Mind becomes so flexible that you decide to practice, I'm going to meditate on a flower. Your experience becomes so intense that you don't see any difference between you and the flower. You become blended with it. Similarly, when you do yoga nidras, you create affirmations in your mind. And if you are highly sensitive, you lose yourself, your own identity, and the affirmation becomes your reality. How much that will depend upon degrees of your success. Just as water assumes the form of any container, so his citta assumed the form of the object that he thought of. So whatever he wanted to meditate upon, he could identify himself with that. I am that. I am the flower. I am the mountain. I am the ocean. I am the pole star. I am the tattvas, elements. One day during his meditative mood, he imagined he was a person known as Jivata. This imagination became a reality in his consciousness. This Jivata, the created personality, continued to live in a city for a long time. This is same way of saying allegorically, as if he dreamt. But in his dream, the experience seemed to him as absolute reality. What did he dream? That he is a person known as Jivata. Jivata comes from jiva, jivatva, sense of individuality. This jivata, the created personality, continued to live in a city for a long time. Must realize it's all in a dream. So time, space in a dream is illusion. But in the realm of illusion, anything is possible. One day, Jivata, intoxicated by drink, entered into sleep. He dreamed that he was a Brahmin, devoted to spiritual studies and the performance of Vedic rites. So first he is a bhikshu. In dream he is a Jivata. Jivata in his dream has now become a Brahmin, devoted to spiritual rites. As time passed, it so happened that this Brahmin too entered into a strange dream. He saw himself as a great king, a monarch, having many kings under his rule. This king developed impressions for worldly enjoyments. During his sleep, he dreamed of being an apsara, a heavenly nymph, given to celestial enjoyments. So now, Jivata, who dreamt that he was a Brahmin, now the Brahmin dreamt he was a great king. And the king dreamt he became an apsara, heavenly nymph. In course of time, the apsara dreamt of being a deer with fickle eyes. Always she heard the word deer, deer, deer. And she became a deer. I'm joking. The deer, in turn, dreamt of being a vine entwining a tree. The vine dreamt of being a black bee. The black bee sported in the midst of lotuses in a lake. It was so enchanted by the nectar of a particular lotus that could not apprehend the approach of a mighty elephant who destroyed the lotus and along with it the black bee. The desires of the dull-witted hasten their destruction. The sight of an elephant at the time of death led the black bee to become the elephant in a dreamlike vision. In other words, the black bee dreams, I am the elephant. The elephant saw himself captured by men and brought into the service of a king. As time passed, during the night, the king was attacked by his enemies. In that battle, the elephant was killed. Since the impressions of the black bee still predominant in his mind, the elephant saw himself in the form of a black bee. This is again another dream. Again the black bee was attached to a lotus. And this is the repeat, the black bee and lotus. And the lotus was destroyed by an elephant. But this time, seeing a swan nearby, the black bee died with the will of being like the swan. Thus it experienced itself as a swan. It went into dream within dream within dream. An advanced stage, swan, hamsa soham. That experience, hamsa soham, I am that, that am I. Allegorically, your soul becomes like a swan. Having wandered through many embodiments, he became a swan of Brahma, the creator. Being in association with Brahma, he attained enlightenment. He became a liberated soul. And this story applies to every soul. Every soul is that Bhikshu Brahmana, becomes Jivata, and dream within dream within dream. And all that you see is a result of dream-like vision, dream within dream experience. In modern technology, it is easy to understand. When you work with your computer, you put in one folder, you put another folder. Within that folder, you put another folder. Within that, you put another one. So one folder makes dreams. Another folder arises. That folder dreams. Another folder arises. And you have millions of topics captured in that process. From one absolute self, countless souls have emerged. And all those souls and all that are needed for their evolution, all these are like dream process. The awakened state for any soul will be, I am the sun. And if you are, I am the sun, you have to also have another understanding. I am all reflected suns. And therefore, as a playing the role of a Jivan Mukta, your heart should radiate, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, may all be happy. For whom should you hold your goodwill? You must understand there is no discrimination, all souls. Not a single soul can be excluded. All souls, no matter whether they look very virtuous or vicious, but all souls are the soul caught in the process of dream within the dream. Becoming a swan, section 63. One day the enlightened swan developed a will. May I become the divine Rudra, that's Bhagwan Shiva. Accordingly, he assumed the form of Shiva and discarded the form of swan. When he says, soham hamsa paramhamsa, it was in the verbal state. Now you become, you realize what you have been uttering, soham hamsa. So from order swan as a vehicle, you became Lord Shiva. As a Rudra, he cast his gaze on his previous embodiments. He was amazed to see the long series of dreams within dreams being united with Shiva. Now his heart opens to countless embodiments that he views them as a dream within dream experience. He remembered how it was by his will that he had entered into the process of embodiment. He assumed the role of the mendicant who was devoted to the practice of samadhi. In a storyline, since these were all dreams, most of them are still there in the world. In brief, imagine in your dream, just to simplify the simile, suppose you have four stages, dream within dream within dream within dream, four experiences. And you have four personalities. Each personality continues to live in the world of relativity. When you wake up to understand you are Shiva, now your heart wants to awaken all those four. So while you are in your status, you are awake. They, in their status, they are still doing their sadhana of different types. And you become like a boon giver, like someone being a channel of divine grace. But he who is a channel of divine grace is you. The one who is being channeled is the same you. And figure that out. Gets mixed up. Now, while all this has gone on, returning back to the mendicant bhikshu, this mendicant, having acquired subtlety of the chitta, had entered into a mental sport of identifying himself with the creation of his imagination. As a result of this, he had become the Brahmin Jivata. Just as an ant continues to wander in tiny holes, so too the soul of Jivata continued to wander into a series of experiences. Out of mere sport, the divine Rudra willed to awaken the dreaming Brahmin Jivata. The self shining in the chitta of the Brahmin awakened him. This led to the awakening of the mendicant, whose dream creation Jivata was. Reflecting upon the wondrous power of Maya, the mendicant joined Bhagavan Shiva, and both flew into the world of Jivata. Jivata, being enlightened, joined Shiva and the mendicant. The story is not to be taken in its precision, who meditates and what gets after, but to understand all are involved in a dream, in dream into a dream, dream within dream type of experience. So now, three personalities came together, this awakened soul that had become Swan, Lord Shiva himself, and this mendicant who is playing the role of Jivata. These three proceeded to awaken and revive all the embodiments of their past dreams. Now their project is a project of Jivan Mukta. A Jivan Mukta can be described like being blended with himself, with God, and with Brahman. All dream embodiments became existing realities belonging to this mayaic world. They all attained Rudrahood. So they end up, these three went on to each dream set, series of dream souls. All those souls are, they are doing their different things. And each soul was awakened, led to enlightenment. It's just like the spirit of the sun awakens all reflected suns. Every reflected sun is the sun. The bhikshu or mendicant is the individual soul. It is essentially the divine self. Governed by beginningless maya or avidya, it enters into the world process and is led by its own will, sankalpa, to encounter different conditions in this apparent world. Its sojourn through the world is depicted by the story of the dream of the mendicant. This is a mystical meaning. The mendicant devoted to meditation acquires the ability of seeing his sankalpa fulfilled. During his meditation, he dreams, as it were, and sees himself as Jivata Brahmin. Jivata, in turn, dreams of being a chieftain. The chieftain dreams of being an emperor. Up until this stage, the soul's involvement in ego is mystically described. Eventually, it becomes a swan of Brahma, the creator. The mystic swan is symbolic of intuitive vision, which separates the self from the illusion of the not self. When the mystic intuition arises, you no longer view yourself as individual souls separated from God. Jiva is Shiva. Having become the swan, he attained the realization of Shivoham, I am Shiva himself. Thus terminates the story of the soul as it wakes up from the long dream of the world process. Having attained enlightenment, it enters into its own dream. No, enters into its own dreams in order to enlighten the personalities with whom it was identified before. In other words, can view all that a sage does, he is helping himself in different dreams. It's just like already story is told. The enlightened sage lives to awaken the souls. In brief, when a sage promotes enlightenment in a disciple, he doesn't view the disciple a different soul. He doesn't view it a process of helping someone else. If that is the way he does, he is not enlightened. Sarve bhavantu sukhina, may all be happy. The all for him is his own self. It's not difficult to understand. All reflected suns are nothing but the sun. So if you have attained that identity with the sun, which is a revelation, that's what you are essentially, then your heart must radiate goodwill for all. So all activities of sage is just like a sage meeting dream personalities, one from one dream, another from dream within dream, another one dream within the dream within the dream. And that type of relationship starts. And just like he has been awakened, each dream person, each person dreaming in whatever status can be awakened. In his inward experience, the sage sees the world as a mirage. Yet from a relative point of view, he continues to perform his duties in this practical world for the upliftment of others. His internal awareness of the transcendental self does not contradict his dream-like personality operating in the world of Maya. The sky-like vision of the sage is not affected by the clouds of illusion. Thus a sage, being Shiva, inherently your identity is Shiva, Shivoham, Shivoham, Satchidananda Swarupoham. I am Shiva. I am the embodiment of Satchit Ananda, existence, consciousness, and absolute bliss. Thus a sage being Shiva continues to awaken Shivahood in others. So, from jivatva state to shivatva state. You were with jiva before and you were awakening jiva hood in others. Lots of hoods. As many moods, so many hoods. But now you are awakening shivatva. This is illustrated in this story. Rudra or Shiva goes back to his dream creations and enlightens them. These enlightened personalities abide with Shiva and finally merge in him. Abiding with Shiva implies attainment of liberation. According to devotional scriptures, the soul, freed of the bondage of the world, ascends these four rungs. Salokya, it abides in the world of God. Samipya, lives in proximity of God. Sarupya, it becomes similar to God. Sayujya, it merges in God. The soul is finally liberated and merges with Shiva or Brahman. And with this we'll conclude. Om. Om. Ram, 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 Ram. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om. Prayer for shower of Karuna, Mayaras, grace of God over all of you, with the blessings of Shakti, Bhakti and Mukti. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe, Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam, Urvarukum Vabandhanan, Mrityor Mukshyamam Ritat. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchid Dukbhag Bhavet. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Hari Om Tat Sat.